Good morning, everybody, and welcome to Hometown Cable. And I'm Bob Venn, your host, and I have a guest this morning here, Bill LePage, the manager. It says it right there, Clinton County Fair manager. If he put his head down, look at that. And he's got some, that should be goal there. He's the commander here at the fair. And Bill, welcome to the show.
Thank you very much, Bob.
And I thank you for allowing us to come in here and talk to you. The fair is opening when this year?
July 31st, and it's going to be running until August 5th. Six days inclusive.
We certainly hope that the weather the last few days isn't going to continue into the end of July.
Well, we hope not, but we've been praying to St. Jude and all the amenities of that. And but frankly, I think most of the rain, this is what usually happens. If we had a lot of rain in June, we usually end up with a good weather for the fair. So I'm not sorry in that respect to see the rain in June.
Okay. Yeah. Bill, before we start into about the fair, when the history of the fair, what's happening here, mm-hmm. Tell us a little bit about Bill LePage.
Well, I'm 62 years old. I was born in Boston, Massachusetts. I moved from Grand Isle, Vermont when I was 8 years old into the city of Plattsburgh, and I've resided there ever since, except for a short stint in the Navy and 6 years in Waterville. And I graduated from St. John's High School. I just recently retired, 5 years ago in fact, from the Clinton Prison in Dannemora, where I worked for 30 years. In 1978 and 79, I was a city alderman for one term, and I chose not to run again. And then after I retired, I figured I had a lot of time, so I ran for the legislature, and I've been successful in three elections.
And you've been manager at the fair?
I've been manager at the fair since 1986.
Okay, now Bill, you're from the south side of the city. You were in the area what we used to know as Fox Hill, nearly.
Well, not quite Fox Hill, but I did live in Ward 2, the old Ward 2. Well, the old Ward is still Ward 2, but it was the old section of Ward 2. I lived on Battery and White Street, and then when I come back to Plattsburgh in 1956. I moved on the west end of Plattsburgh, and I've lived there since then. And that's the area that I represent in the county legislature. In fact, I didn't tell you about the county legislature.
No, not yet. Well, you mentioned you were legislator
three times, but I do represent the middle of the city. The middle, that's the Ward 2 section of the city.
Mm-hmm. You want to thank the people there for voting for you last time?
Well, definitely.
Look at that here. This is being shown on North as well as Plattsburgh.
Well, I'm always appreciative of any votes I get, and I have a lot of friends, and I think I've always had an advantage. I've lived in the city all my life, and in Ward 2 just about all my life. So I've had an advantage there, and then probably I'm doing a good job. That's why I've been reelected.
Very good. Now, what does a manager of a fair do, and how long do you work? What months?
Well, starting about May 1st until maybe the end of August or the middle of August, it's a full-time job. Other than that, we take care of storage in the fall. We store anything that people want to store here during the fair or during that year. During that time, I probably come up and answer the phone a couple of times and take care of the mail through the whole year. But there's nothing demanding saying that I should be here all the time, because there's really nothing going on.
Well, now, when you say you come and check the mail and so forth, I saw two ladies in the office. Are they here all year round?
No. In fact, we just started Monday, July 1st. We started working full-time in the office, and one of the ladies out there, as Rose Duque, has been with me for my duration at the fair, and she was here many years before that. And the other young lady is in the JTPA program that is sponsored by the county.
I just saw Steve Bittard, my nephew,
right
out here.
Steve is a counselor for JTPA during the summertime, and he's been here as long as I've been.
Okay, now they talk about volunteers for the fair. Yours is a paid job.
Yes, it is.
Underpaid, obviously, but still paid?
They're still paid, yes.
Okay, who pays you? Who runs the Clinton County Fair?
Okay, we have a board of directors made up of 24 people from all parts of the county, the city and the county, from the north, the south. They're spread out quite a bit. And every year we have an annual election, and people are welcome to apply for a membership as a director. And at the annual election, we elect these 24 board members again. And over and above that, I'm secretary manager, and Tom Mercadante is a treasurer. So actually, the The hierarchy of the whole fair is probably consists of 26 people.
But is it run by the county, or is it just Clinton County Fair, because that's where it's located?
No, we're an independent incorporated fair association.
Okay, it is.
Yes, and we're fortunate enough to get we are a contract agency with the county, and they do supply us with a contract amount every year.
So the county legislature doesn't tell you what to do here? They don't have any input as far as that?
None whatsoever.
Okay, we'll take a short break and see if we can find the list of directors, and maybe we can come back and you could...
Okay.
I'm sure if you try to remember all 24, you might forget somebody, so...
Well, no, but I'll try.
We'll try?
Yeah.
Or we'll get the list.
We can start right on right now, if I can get the list.
Okay, just take a short break.
Okay.
For anybody just joining us, we're back now, and Bob Venn, your host, with our guest Bill LePage, the manager at Clinton County Fair, who's just obtained a list of the directors for the fair, and we'd like to hear their names, maybe.
Okay. I'd like to start off with the officers of the board. Donald Duquette from the town of Plattsburgh is the president. The first vice president is Dr. Lynn Palmer from Plattsburgh. He owns a veterinary establishment up on the Beekman Town Road. The second vice president is Kenneth Dumas, who is the business agent for the local union, laborers union in Plattsburgh. And the third vice is Bob Irwin, a farmer from Peru. And our representative at large is Kenneth Place. He's also a farmer from Peru. And myself, I'm the secretary manager. And Tom Mercadante from Peru is the treasurer. Now, the board consists of Homer Bushy from Champlain, who also takes care of the FFA department in the fair. Bob Bruno from Peru is also the chairman of the legislature. He's a member of the board and has been a member of the board for many, many years, and a past president, I might say. Jack Connell from Keysville is a board member, and he... him and Sandy Latterell, who was also a board member, handled the harness racing end of our fair. Harry Carpenter is a member of the board, and he's involved in the horse show along with Robert Briette from Dannemora. Ray Levineway from Saranac handles the draft horse show. I better look at my notes. I don't want to forget anybody. And Carl Madonna is a board member, and he's been very valuable in handling some of our legal things that we have to do it every year. Bernard Barber is the supervisor of the town of Scarlet Falls and has been a member for many, many years and a past president. And Harold Ornsby, who also from Scarlet Falls, has been a past president and has been a member for many, many years. Bob Perrier is a new member. He lives on Hammond Lane in Plattsburgh, and he was appointed to take his father's place, Ernie Perrier, who was a longtime member, who just resigned shortly after the first of the year. Harry Parks from Peru has been a longtime director of the fair. Harold Rabideau is fairly new, 2 or 3 years ago, is from Morrisonville, and he's a member. He's one of the board members. Bob Rabideau, who preceded me as manager, is a board member now, and he was manager for 13 years, and the fair really saw a lot of improvement and took a lot of important leaps and established the fair of what it is today. And Richard Stafford, who has been a longtime member, is a farmer from Peru, and he's a retired farmer, I might say, and but a very valued member of our organization. And Bruce Bell from West Chazee takes care of our horse pull, and he's a very valuable member of he's heads of personnel committee, so anybody that's hired and fired goes through his committee. Arnold Joubert is a new member. He's a postmaster from Morrisonville, but a very active member. And he's in the 2 years that he's been here, he's been proved to be very active.
If I could just interrupt you here, sure. Arnold Joubert is one of my best friends. He and I went to high school together in Moores, freshman and sophomore.
Oh, yeah.
He's my son's godfather. I'm a godfather. He's a Red Joubert, a good friend, and hello, Red, if you're watching there in Morrisonville. And
I'm going to have to tell Red to make sure to watch this program.
Yes.
And Lester Hardy, who has been I think he's been on the board for about 30 years. He's from Cumberland Head, and he's another very valuable person that you want to talk to for some advice. He's always got an answer for everything. And let me see if I've missed anybody here. I guess, Helen Sprague, she's a businesswoman in the Plattsburgh Plaza. she's involved with a fine arts program here, and she really has been a very active member in the last 2 years that she's been a member. And I think I mentioned Sandy Latterell, but I wouldn't want to forget her. She's probably one of the more active members that we have. She's involved with fine arts, domestic arts, and she heads the 3 days of harness racing that we have here on the grounds, and that's a very successful harness race program, I might add. And I guess that's about it.
That covers all your people.
I hope I haven't missed anybody. But
as you can hear what Bill's talking about here, that you can see that it's not if you come here for 4 hours to visit the fair and enjoy yourself, you can see that there's been an awful lot of work by an awful lot of people and a lot of planning to make your day and your successful.
Yeah, very, very much so. We have at the time, if I could take the opportunity to thank all of our volunteers, and if I started naming them, I don't think I'd better, because I'm sure I'm going to miss some, and I don't
absolutely
want to offend anybody. But the fair could not be run without the volunteers that help at the fairgrounds.
And those are from throughout the county?
Yes, they are.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And have you any idea how many there might be in number?
Oh, gee, there must
10, 50?
There must be 50.
50 or more.
50, yeah.
And I'd like to add Hometown Cable's thank you also to you people. And this is the first time we've been to the fair before it opened to tell you what's going to happen. We understand this will be shown about the 29th of July, just before it opens.
Good.
So that you will have be right in time, okay?
Yeah, very good.
And now, if I come here with my family, mm-hmm. what's it going to cost me to get in if I come only one time?
Okay, the adult admission at the gate is $4, and anybody, a child 12 to 15, we have to charge $2. And anybody under 12 is free. Senior citizens are admitted on Senior Citizen Day for $3. Any other day, they're charged the adult price. And then, the rides are determined. The price of the rides are determined by the midway operator, which we don't have anything to do with that. But he has set the prices this year. You can buy an advance sale. You can buy a book of or a sheet of tickets worth $10 for $5. Also, they will have an $8 wristband day, which is you buy a wristband and you can ride continually all day for.
You know what day that is?
No, not yet. I'm not sure.
Okay, so watch for that. Watch the local paper for advertising and so forth. That $8 day sounds like a great thing.
Yes, it is.
Now,
and by the way, all the season, we have season passes for $14.
That's for one person.
For adults, for one person.
Right.
And $7 for a child between 12 and 15. And we have daily passes. If they buy them pre-sale, they're sold for $3, saving a dollar, of course,
right.
And for adults, and they're $1.50 for a child, and it'll save a child 50 cents. And all of these tickets, that's for the gate tickets, ride tickets, they're all on sale at the present time in the Champlain Center North Mall, and also at the Price Chopper store.
Okay, now you remember this is going to be shown probably around the 29th, mm-hmm. so they've got 2 days or.
Well,
you're opening the 31st, you said?
Yes.
So they don't have 2 weeks to do this before, because by the time you see this and this offer he's telling you, there'll be other, you probably have seen it in the paper, but if you haven't got your season pass yet, do it for two reasons. It's going to make it nice and less expensive for you, and if you've got it, you're going to come more often, going to make Bill happy, and all the other people here who've worked so hard, and number three, they need the money to keep the fair going.
Sure.
What kind of budget do you work on?
Well, our budget runs around $250,000 a year.
It's a lot of money.
Yes.
I didn't realize it was that high. Now, the people who display, do they have to pay to display?
Yes, they do. We have a charge. First of all, nonprofit organizations, we don't charge them for space in the fairgrounds. The paid vendor or the vendors that come in here, inside and outside space, we charge $12 a foot. Food vendors pay $400. And that's this is for the week now. This mm-hmm. is one charge for the week. And we have some inside spaces that go for $275. They're a garage space that's attached, or the key is supplied to the vendor, and they open and close when they like, you know.
How many acres does your fair consist of?
Well, we have 80 acres, and we're developing now, we're in the process of developing an additional 10 acres for parking. During some nights of the fair, about three nights of the last year, we were just crying for parking space. So for the last 3 years, we've been working on this additional parking, and as money allowed, we've been developing it. And I don't know if it'll all be done this year, but I'm sure we're going to have another, at least another 3 acres of parking this year, so it won't be too bad, you know.
Bill, what did you have to have for attendance for you to consider it to be successful attendance-wise?
If we go over 20,000, we figure it's a successful affair, and of course we give an enormous amount of free tickets away, and of course we figure that anybody that helps us, we're going to help them, and then when they come to the fair, they're going to spend money, and that keeps the vendors happy and keeps them coming back, and we wouldn't have a very good fair without the vendors, for sure.
Right. Now, you have a night show, afternoon show, mm-hmm. The special people come in to sing, and the Jack Kochman's Hell Drivers and so forth, are they coming this year?
Well, it isn't Jack Kochman. It's
anymore?
It's Charlie Belknap's Hollywood Stunt Show. They've been here for the last 2 years, and we decided to retain them again this year, because last year he played to a packed grandstand, and well, a packed grandstand means money in everybody's pockets,
right.
You might say.
Okay, do they pay special for that show, or is that part of your...
Okay, now, we'll start on Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. That's the first 3 nights of the fair. The grandstand is free. Now, on Tuesday night, we're having Andy Andrews, who is the... if anybody watches the Nashville Network, he's been on there numerous times. He's a very, very talented comedian, and he'll put on an hour and 15 minute show without stopping, and it's just continuous laughter. I mean, I watched him last January in Syracuse, and he really put on a good show, and that convinced us to our entertainment committee to hire him. And preceding Andy on the show, we hired Kelly Garver, who was the third runner-up to Miss America in 1987, and she finished first in the talent contest of that show. And she's another sort of comedian. She plays violin, and she involves the audience to a great extent in her show, and that was another reason that we hired her, because she really, involving the audience the way she does, I mean, it's a riot to watch the whole thing.
And what night are they?
That's on Tuesday.
That's Tuesday, and that's that open now, so to speak, and you buy your ticket, and it's admission to the show.
The gate is paid, but it's a free grandstand. The
free grandstand to see this, right?
Now, Wednesday night, Ben Everest, puts on what they call the Pepsi Lip Sync Local Talent Show. It's sponsored by the Pepsi-Cola Company, and it's all local people, and that's always a well-attended show, because relatives come and see the kids perform, and it's one of the shows that I get a chance to watch a little bit because of the local talent, and it's always interesting to see local talent. Then on Thursday, that's a free grandstand also, and then on Thursday night, we have, like I mentioned before, Charlie Belknap's Hollywood Stunt Show. They use pickup trucks to perform stunts in front of the grandstand, up and down the main course of the track. And they, at the conclusion of the show, they use the big, what they call, I guess it's something like Bigfoot. It's a truck with big. Big tires on it, you know, that you've seen
mm-hmm.
on TV,
yes.
And they'll crush it. We have to get some old cars for them, and they'll run up on top of them and crush them and go back and forth and sort of race on top of the trucks or the cars. And overall, it's a really, really exciting show. I mean, and it keeps the people right on the edge of their seats, so to speak. Now, the last 3 days of the show, that's Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, we have a $3 admission to the grandstand in addition to the front gate. Now, the Friday night is the annual tractor pull, which is a very attractive and popular event here. And that's one show. It'll start at 7 and run until about 11:30 or 12 o'clock. So it's well worth the price of admission just to watch those guys compete for the prizes and trophies that we provide. And then on Saturday, we're having our top star attraction of Charlie McLean and her husband, Wayne Massey. She's been a country western star for a number of years, and a real talented lady, and we're hoping that the people in Clinton County will take advantage to see Charlie. And I've watched her show in Syracuse also, and she's a real talented person, really, really good. And then on Sunday is probably the premier event of the whole fair, and that's we have a demolition derby in the afternoon at 2 o'clock, and then we have another one at night, and it's last year we had two full grandstands to both those shows, and it's probably the best attended event of the whole week.
I want to remind you people out there who are watching Hometown Cable that my name is Bob Venn. The show is What's Going On Here, And this is Bill LePage, my guest, and let me tell you something. He knows what he's talking about. He's got this down pat, and we're very happy to have him on our show this morning. But we're going to move around the fairgrounds now and show us some of the buildings that have gone up and to kind of change our scenery here, he and I, and stretch our legs a little bit. So we'll be coming right back to you shortly. What you're looking at is a picture here in the office at the fair. We're not up in a helicopter or anything. Bill, I wanted to take Bill up in a helicopter. He said he's afraid of heights.
Certainly.
Right, Bill, this is overall a good overall picture of your fair. Mm-hmm. And can you kind of point out the main things in here? For instance, where are we right now?
Right now we're in this building. This is the office right here.
Okay.
Okay. Now, the main buildings would be like these two buildings here are exhibitor buildings. We have paid and non-paid non-profit exhibitors. This building here, this one is the 4-H building. That is probably the busiest building during the whole fair because we have a lot of kids around.
We had a slight interruption. A man came in looking for a job, and we Bill's laughing at that. It's not really true. But we were talking about the 4-H building, Bill.
Okay, the 4-H building is probably the busiest building that we have in the grounds because of the number of people or kids, I might say, that enter into the competitions that the 4-H puts on during the fair. And their competitions, by the way, are at staggered times throughout the fair, so it would be advisable for any entrant to or anybody that comes into the fair to get a copy of the schedule, of the 4-H schedule. And then right preceding east and the fairgrounds, this is the FFA building. That's Future Farmers of America is what FFA is, and they have about 40 people that really put on some exhibitions with their cattle and cleaning and shows how cattle should be groomed. And right next door is the cattle barn, and that's probably the biggest barn that we have, and we have a number of farmers in the area that participate with and their children with their livestock.
This building here has got to be a home nearly of Homer Bushy when he comes down here, I take
that's
it.
Homer Bushy has this
one. Yes, right here. Farmers, right?
Mm-hmm.
Very active. He does a great job. We see his picture in the paper with his Northern Adirondack people, and he's a Champlainer back there. Hello, Homer.
The FFA is an active organization other than the fairgrounds. They enter all kinds of state competitions in speech, and farming. It's a very, very varied program, and they're well represented. Our county is well represented by our local FFA and the in-state competitions.
Okay, then here's another big building.
Okay, this is the Fine Arts and Domestic Arts building. They used to be located here, but we put an addition on this building last year. You can't see the addition, but it's on there, but they grew out of that addition, so we decided to put them in a bigger building instead of spending more money to enlarge the buildings. So, by the way, that's where anybody that was located in this building last year is going to be located here. And one of our customers is in the office right now. I'm just saying that for his benefit.
See you later, Jim.
Okay.
This is the grandstand
right
here, right?
Mm-hmm. This is the grandstand, and this is everything that's taken. Well, this stage usually sets in the back here when we have the track competitions going on. But when we have shows coming in, we move the stage up. It's on wheels, and we move it up closer to the grandstand. Now, this building here and this building are all exhibitors' buildings. And these are garage-type spaces that people rent the garage for the week of the fair. And they're supplied with a key so they can open and close them when they wish. Now, this area here, this whole area here is all the Midway area, the Carnival, Amusements of America. And that's a big part of the fair. It's a real big part of the fair. If they weren't here, we probably would be kind of lonesome during fair week. But this year, he's promised me that they're going to have an additional couple new rides that sure are sure to please the patrons. Now, this area here, we have a brand new conservation building. It's pretty, you can't see it, it's not in this picture. But this staffed by the Fish and Game Clubs and the Department of Environmental Conservation. Last year it had more people going in that barn than I thought would go in because it's in the back sort of the fairgrounds where the activities aren't such. But it was well attended, and we're looking for a big increase of people visiting that area
Let's just take a small break here as we leave the woods, and we'll be right back to you.
Okay.
We're talking with Bill LePage, the Clinton County Fair Manager, and he's just telling us about this wooded area, and we're moving kind of a southeast direction, Bill. You've got a couple other big buildings here.
Yeah. This area back here is for our horse shows, and the right here is the horse ring, and this has been completely redone this year because the fence was pretty well shot. But our horse shows are, we probably have 150 entrants in that horse show before everybody signed up. Now, moving over this way, this is the track. This is the first 3 days of the show. We have harness racing from 12 to 3 in the afternoon. In this area here on Saturday is the draft. We'll have the draft horse show, and that's usually pretty well attended. And the horse pull is at the same time is going on in front of the grandstand. So there's activities just about all the time in front of the grandstand. Now, we have the parking lot that I was talking about. The addition of the parking lot is over in this area here. You can just see the corner of it. It's not really ready to be used yet, but we hope a part of it that we started 3 years ago will be used this year. And this area right around the office is for handicapped areas, and we ordinarily that they come in on buses. We have buses from the ARC, from the hostels coming in around the county, and they'll park in this area here, and it makes it easier for them access to the regular to the grounds. This is our main parking. This is main parking. Back here is main parking, and over in this area over here that you can't see, this area here is all main parking lots.
Now, if you're coming by plane, your own plane rather than your car, this is the runway right here. Remember, it's the one with the white lines. The one with the yellow is for cars. Do not land here. But that's how close you are to the north-south runway at the Clinton County Airport is right here, and which is getting a lot of business. Must be very happy with your airport now.
Definitely.
As a legislator.
We're setting all-time records as far as enplanements.
Sure. As a matter of fact, my wife went to Florida, and she left out of the Plattsburgh Airport for the first time ever. We used to go to Burlington or Montreal.
Yep.
She flew out of here. And, now to close this off here, there's about 80 acres, you said.
Right, 80 acres.
And when did the fair, which we know used to be down on Bailey Avenue and a few other
Sharon
locations,
Avenue.
When did it physically come up into this location?
It's the first fair here was in the summer of 1954, and we've been here ever since.
36 years, and I remember it. All right, is there anything else that I did not cover here, Bill, that you'd like to cover that I didn't ask you?
Oh, one of our new buildings, and we can probably take some pictures of it later. We have a new gazebo, and it's right here in the center of this, of what we call the mall area. And we've eliminated the Astrodome, so we cleared that space so everybody could use this instead of this. And we've also put an addition on the office. During the week of the fair, we're just crowded for space in the office, and so the buildings and ground, the president decided to do something about that this year.
Okay, one more thing. There's some buildings that people look for very, very often when they're on the fairgrounds, and that's the restrooms.
Oh.
And if they can prepare ahead of time so they won't go around looking, where are the restrooms here?
They're probably the most important ones we have.
Yes.
I'm glad you asked me that. This is, we have one right here in the parking lot, the main parking lot. Then there's one in the conservation area. You just probably see the top of the building right here. Then there's one over in the race, near the race track, and there's one right under the grandstand, right here.
Make a record of those, folks, because if you're bringing children, you're going to be there an awful lot. Now, obviously, people have to make registrations to become, to display something.
Mm-hmm.
How late can people out there who are watching this, if we probably have this on before the 29th, locally, when could, and how do they...
All the entries have to be in by the Friday before fair, which is the 27th, I believe, this year. If anybody wants to enter, you can enter the fine arts, which is here. They can enter the horse shows, the cattle building. Let me see. I'm trying to.
Now they would call this office and get information.
Oh yeah.
What's your number here?
Or is 561-7998. Anyway, to enter an article in the fine arts, for instance, or domestic arts, the person has to pay a $7 membership fee, and they become a member of the fair.
For a year?
For that year, yes. And then they pay 10% of the first premium prize, which is a, in that department. Like if the first premium prize is $10, then they have to pay $1 to enter a certain article in the fair. Now, if you could just give me a second, I can tell the Denver departments they can get into.
Okay, we'll just take a short break. We're still overhead at the fair, looking down from our standing on a chair here in the office with Bill LePage, and he's going to tell us some more about making entries. Bill, you went and got some information.
Yes, as I said before, I explained how a person enters an article in the fair, and some of the departments that a person can enter are the fine arts and domestic arts, the culinary department, farm and garden, plants and flowers, honey, maple sugar, and cattle. Okay?
Now, when he said honey, he wasn't talking to anybody in particular out there. That's an event that he can enter, the honey group. And 1954, you said it started in here. Mm-hmm. Half-mile track, right? Mm-hmm. And you have harness racing. Mm-hmm. And we just about covered, I guess, what you got here, Bill.
Yeah, I think I might mention, too, that we have 68 full-service campsites. They're located in this area here and all along here.
Okay. Now, there's three buildings here we didn't mention, or five. I know one of them is the art and the prison.
This is the Clinton Correctional Building, right?
Okay,
here.
That's very popular.
This is our Grange Building.
Okay.
Grange Building. Right here we have three or four restaurants right in a row right here. These are vendors that have permanent buildings, but they use those buildings every year.
Mm-hmm. Okay, we're going to go outside and see the physical buildings now. And as we go, we're going to show you some of the pictures of people who have starred here in the grandstand in mm-hmm. the past. That's mm-hmm. correct?
That's true.
I'm assuming that. And
oh, yeah. We've had Jerry Reed here, Tommy Hunter, Barbara Mandrell. As we go down there, let's see, John Schneider, Barbara Fairchild last year, Boxcar Willie. That was some of the more famous ones. And Brenda Lee, of course, we can't forget her. That's one of my favorites. And Barbara's sister Louise Mandrell. Shenandoah was here last year. They were really a good show. They really put on a nice show.
Mm-hmm. And I noticed on the wall here, Bill, it gives a list of the New York fairs in the state of New York.
Yes.
And apparently here there's 56 separate state fairs in the state of different counties, right?
That's right.
And
by the way, we have the reputation of being the cleanest grounds in the state. I'd like to really mention that because it's true.
Well, let's name who's in charge of your cleaning grounds. Who's in charge of that?
Buildings and Grounds is also the president. I told you, Donald Duquette. He's in charge of Buildings and Grounds.
Is that Duquette in relation to this lady sitting over here?
Yes, it is.
Is that?
Some relationship.
I wonder if Calvin might just swing around and see these two people. They may not want to talk to us here, but they can see the two people who are working in the office and someone just coming in to make an entry. Tell us this lady's name. You're going to give us her own name.
Lisa.
All right, Lisa. And Rose Duquette with the typewriter and a lady who's visiting us who wants to win the contest with the vegetables, we'll say. She got a kick out of that.
I don't know which one she's entering.
Okay. And we'll be going out and we'll see you back on the ground. Well, thanks very much. Well, I don't know if you've missed us, but we're back and we're sitting out here and Calvin's showing you the office that we just left. And he'll pan the buildings up along the side as we're right. We're sitting in front of the 4-H Club, and we're in the gazebo. Tell us about this new building.
Well, we have some local talent that usually performs every day at the in the late afternoon around supper time for everybody's enjoyment. And last year, some of the bands complained about a lack of space and cover from the wind and rain, and so we decided to build a gazebo, which. You know, it's an attractive addition to the fair. A gazebo seems to go with outdoor activities, you know.
A place to come in and just sit like we are right here now,
yeah.
You know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You're talking about space. Didn't your kids ever tell you that they don't give enough space?
Yeah, right.
Hey, we were just coming in here, and Calvin, of course, he's the one that always spots the money. But look what I just picked up right here. We figured somebody's been throwing money here. And I picked up.
It wasn't me.
And it's five. Now, Calvin said that he thought it might have been Bill seeding the grounds so that when they come in the first day, they'll find it. Huh?
Seeding the grounds with pennies?
Yes. Well, there's bigger ones out there somewhere. We just happen to start here, that's all. Like Hansel and Gretel, see? Right, as you see, it's a lovely day. The sky is blue, nice white clouds. And this, who built the gazebo? Who does your construction like this?
Our president, who is also buildings and grounds. He has a crew of men that come in and work. They're putting additions on a couple of
Is this volunteer?
No,
that's paid. Okay.
These are paid.
All right, now you're looking at your industrial event straight ahead here, the big building. And then Calvin just showed you the three food buildings. And now this building was the senior citizens, I think?
This is the Grange.
The Grange. And then the
Correctional
with their paintings and their various projects that they do.
Right.
And what a lovely day. Wouldn't this be a great day to open the fair just like this?
I'd like to have 6 days just like
just
this.
Like this. You want to believe it. People just want to get out, Bill, and I'm sure you can see the mountains in the background up over the office. Beautiful view here. And I'm sure this will be a very, very popular building you have here.
Definitely.
And the building just to the right of the office, I might add, as Calvin pans over there, the dark, that is what?
The North Country Squares building. It's a square dance organization. They have their meetings here. They use the building for other organizations that meet, and they also have a food vendor during the fair.
Okay, so did that building use during the fair for anybody? Can you go in there?
Well, we do use it for a 4-H dog show. Other than that, it's not used for anything else. It's available to be used, but nobody's ever asked to use it.
Also, I'm looking back here, and I noticed three flagpoles between here and your office. So what flags do you fly there?
Oh, we fly the U.S. flag, the state flag, and the county flag.
Okay, they're all flying right out there in front. Look for these things when you come to the fair, folks. And now, we saw in the office picture what was here before. It was
an Astrodome type of building. And it was all right, but it just got away. It wasn't big enough. There wasn't enough room to begin with. And we were going to repair it this year and try to even add on to it. But then we decided that it was a little bit beyond repair, so we just took it right down and built this.
So, Bill, except for those 6 days or the 2 weeks before and the week after you're shutting down, these buildings are vacant all year long?
No.
No, okay, no, correctly.
We starting after October 1st, we store boats, cars, campers, whatever anybody has to store. We rent
a little bit of income for the...
Right. We use the barns all year because it's really found money for the fair and helps us keep the prices out of the gate.
Are any horse shows held there other than during the fair?
Mm-hmm. The Champlain Valley Morgan Horse Club has their annual show here the last part of May. Middle of June, the Dannemora Horse Club has their show. The 4-H has a horse camp right around the 1st of May, and then they have another dairy camp about the 1st of June. And let me see, St. John's has their, which kicks off the season around the area with their annual bazaar. They have it here at the fairgrounds.
Remember, folks, that you have a flea market later in the summer right here?
Not all the time. I think we're going to have one this year. Somebody called me about that the other day.
These things, I'm sure you people did not know. I did not know them, and I thought I knew some of the things. And all these things have taken place and under the leadership of the board of directors and their manager right here, Bill LePage. And it's just such a different day than yesterday, Bill. It's a different situation when you get the sun out.
Bob, I'd like to just mention one other thing. Through the good graces of the Department of Correction, namely the Altona Correctional Facility and the Gabriels up in Paul Smith's, we have these inmate community service gangs that come here and help us get the grounds ready. And as you can see, they've really done a fantastic job, and they'll keep the grounds in this shape until the fair starts. And this year, they're coming back after the fair to help us clean up. And we're more than indebted for them. We can't thank them enough for the services that they provide us.
They've also done to the village of Champlain.
Right.
They've been
yes.
in, and they help out all our streets. They've done the ditches.
Yes.
And they're nice people. You kind of forget that they don't have the freedom that we do,
that's
but
right.
they're very good, helpful to us.
We don't have, there's not a one, in the 3-5 years that I've been here, and we've had them every year, there hasn't been one disciplinary problem here. And they love to come here.
I'm
in fact,
sure
they
do.
Look forward to it every year.
Sure. Now, you'll look out here. The blacktop sidewalk is being covered with What kind of brick do you call
patio,
that?
Patio bricks.
Patio brick. Look at the nice design in here. Mm-hmm. And there's the bricks. They're getting ready to be laid. Mm-hmm. Are they laid? Is there cement in that also?
No,
are they just laid there?
They're sitting on the, what do you call this? That's ore dust right there.
Oh, that's ore dust. Yes. No, that wasn't a blacktopping there at all.
No,
that's all. Well, that's my second mistake of the day. My first one was to come and talk to Bill at all.
Yeah.
No, I'm sure you're enjoying this show, and Bill's a great host, and we thank him very much. And we got a plane overhead leaving from the Clinton County Airport. Looks like a personal, look, it's one of the commuters.
That's a commuter, yeah.
Heading out towards Saranac Lake?
Well, he's probably, he's going to Lake Placid.
Lake Placid,
yeah.
On that.
Yeah.
Okay, we'll go to another location. Stand by. We've moved into the entrance to the Future Farmers of America building here at the fair, and the building is very different now than what it will be in 2 weeks, and that's why, a month plus. It's going to be the 31st of July through August the 5th.
Yeah.
And this is what's happening. We just mentioned to us that storage, and you can see some of the storage still here.
Yeah, some of the people... the boat you see there, the gentleman doesn't have a rig on his car yet to come and get it, but I told him within the next week or so he's ought to come and get it, because we got to start cleaning this building up. this building is in, right now there's a lot of stuff all over the place, but it will be cleaned up, and stanchions put up for all the cattle. And the future farmers, the entrance, that people that enter cattle stay here for the 6 days to tend their animals and participate in the fair.
I think someone's here to pick up that truck. Let's take a short break. We're back, and I was wrong. The person wasn't looking for that truck. I think the person with that truck forgot it, Bill.
Probably did.
Anyone ever forget to come pick up their vehicle?
Not yet.
Not yet.
Not yet.
Okay, getting back, you mentioned about the exhibitors, the young people staying here overnight?
Yes, they stay here for the 6 days of the fair, and probably but they're here about 7 days total. And they bring their animals here, and they groom them, ready for their FFA judging, and they stay here with them, taking care of their animals.
What do they have? They have a cot they bring in?
They have bunks. Yeah, they sleep right here, and they cook here, they eat here, they do the whole thing for the week. And this building and the department, the FFA department, is supervised, as I said before, by Homer Bushy. And one thing I failed to mention about Homer was that he was he's a past president of the fair, and he was the president the first 2 years that I was manager, and he's a great guy to work with.
Very active, and does a great job with the kids. And then now these are some of the small cages you mentioned.
Yeah, they'll the FFA kids will enter rabbits, chickens, any small animal that they have, and they're judged too.
Now there'll be a lot more of these cages.
There's a total amount. We have them here and over here. They'll be along the sides.
Okay, there'll be animals in there.
Animals.
Oh, that's right. You got the calves and the heifers and the other things in here also. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And you see some of their FFA banners up here. And a very popular building, as Bill mentioned, here. And what... Oh, this is Exhibitors Pavilion. What happens in here?
It's just a sign for people to see. Exhibitors.
Oh, okay.
But this is their kitchen where they do their cooking.
Okay.
And I sort of have to apologize for the shape of the building that it's in, but as you can see, the tools all over the place. Where
you just got here Monday, you mentioned,
yeah, right?
Getting ready to go. You got a full month, nearly a month, to get at it and bring it back into shape.
Oh, it'll be in shape.
I'm sure it will. Yeah. When will they start bringing their animals here?
They'll start about Sunday of the fourth, let's say it'd be the 29th. The 29th.
Okay, 20th, now,
30th.
Do you also have a rule that once they bring their animal, they must stay to the end of the show?
Oh, yeah. Everything that's entered in the fair has to stay until the fair is
full,
over.
So when you come here the last day of the fair, the 4th or the 5th, you're not going to miss some of the exhibits. They might be a little tired by the last day. So why don't you don't come the last day, or come the last day and the first day and the middle day? Yeah. Come three times.
But state ags and markets law says that anybody that pays an entrance at the gate is entitled to see the fair in its entirety.
Okay, and we came in, you mentioned another building just to the side here.
Yeah.
By the fireman's building.
Yes, the Clinton County Firemen's Association building. This was this building was moved up here from South Platte Street in the city, so-called Fox Hill that you're talking about.
Oh, yes. Now it's Fox Heights, I understand, as I moved away.
Right. So that was the old Rescue Hose number 5 building, and the firemen moved it up here. It was quite an undertaking, but we had the foundation already, and they set it right on the foundation.
They brought the whole width at one time?
Yep.
That's a big, may not be that heavy, but it certainly is wide.
They had to have
big.
special traffic and traveling permits.
I'm sure. Now, there's your industrial exhibit. That these are the garage, as he mentioned, doors.
These garages are about measure 20 by 20, and exhibitors come in there and set up the display the way they want to. We have the Navy, Marines, National Guard here. We're just.
Do you have trouble leasing out those? Or do you, enough people?
These exhibit spaces are the ones that go first because they're supplied a key, so they can open them up. They want to open up a little bit late that day or stay here as long as the carnival is open. They can stay open, and because the exhibit buildings, I lock them up at 9:30 at night.
Okay. So are these all the same rates? People all pay the same rate?
Yes, in these garages.
Then I guess it's okay. You could tell us what it is. No one's going to feel like he's paying more than anybody else.
We get $275 for a week.
You mentioned that. For the week, $275, which they I'm sure they get an awful lot of leads. If they don't sell anything that day, they get an awful lot of leads while they're here.
You can see all the grassy area along the paths, along the roads, is all it's frontage for that. We get $12 a foot for vendors to display along the grass.
That's a running foot, not a square foot.
A running foot.
Right.
A running foot. And food vendors in that square over there where you can see we have a lot of about four or five food vendors right in that one central area right there.
You mentioned $400
for the week. Yeah. Plus they have to supply an insurance policy.
Now the pump house, you have your own well here, is that the idea?
And we have a brand, that's another thing I failed to mention that we've done this year. You can see where all the crushed stone is from starting from way out there. Out by the front gate. We have a water line coming from the town of Plattsburgh that ends right there. So we put an 8-inch water line from there all the way to the pump house this year with the addition of a fire hydrant that's outside the prison building over there. We needed some extra added fire protection. And next year we're hoping to extend the water line to the back to the south end of the field with another fire hydrant put in place.
I don't like to be repetitious, but what we're trying to impress on you people out there is that you just don't open the door and say, well, let's start the fair. There's a lot of work.
It's a year-round job. It's not a steady year-round job, but people are working on the fair in some aspect or in one or another for the whole year.
And even when you're not doing the work, you're planning, right?
Definitely.
Lots of planning goes there. Nothing takes place unless it's planning. Now, this is the big cattle barn itself, and it has the show ring inside.
Yes.
That's a very active building also?
Oh, yes. I think it was something like a total of 60 entries in the cattle barn last year. So as a result, you know, we need a lot of space. And we're in the process of hooking up fans now inside the cattle barn just to relieve the moisture and the heat inside.
You mentioned, I know when you were reading and telling me about the board of directors, maybe five or six from Peru.
Oh, yeah.
Big farmers from Peru.
Farmers, yeah. And they enter cattle. And that's what got them interested in the fair in the first place.
Yep.
They're very active. The farmers are really active in our, as you can
say. Well, that's where the fair started, right? With the farming, it was,
fair, right?
It was the agricultural, is what it is. Well, we'll just walk over and see the grandstand, and maybe we can get a view down and toward the horse barn.
Okay.
And we're talking again, to remind you, this is what's going on here with Bob Venn, and our guest today is Bill LePage, and doing a great job of telling us about your, not his, not mine, your Clinton County Fair. Be here, patronize it, enjoy it, and you can talk about it with your friends and neighbors.
Yep, we hope so.
Okay.
Okay.
What you're looking at is the superstructure, the grandstand here at the Clinton County Fair. If you've just tuned in, we're at the Clinton County Fair, and we're in the southeast corner just about, and we're looking as Calvin pans. You see the horse barns down below. And then the horse trailers, and this is the cafe, St. John's Shamrock Cafe, it says here.
Mm-hmm.
And this good-looking gentleman right here next to me, this very business-looking gentleman, is Bill LePage. He's the manager at the Clinton County Fair. He's also his legislator. You've probably seen him on TV. He's not controversial. He's just a good, smiling guy. Look at him. He's a retired correction officer.
Okay, what Calvin is scanning now is... all these grassy areas alongside the roads will be filled with vendors that will be here for the 6 days of the fair. They're usually crafts and probably trailers and campers and hopefully some car dealers will participate this year.
Bill, if someone had a car or a boat that he has no place to put it. Can he contact you and see if you got any spaces available?
Definitely.
You encourage it.
Oh, I encourage it.
All right.
You can call me at the fair number. It's 561-7998.
Remember,
and Calvin is now he's scanning our horseshoe pit area. We have we're going to have our sixth annual horseshoe tournament this year, and that seems to be growing every year. A few more participants every year, and I sort of like to watch the competition myself, but I'm a sort of an amateur shooter myself.
Is that a one-day competition?
Yes, it is.
What day is that?
That's on Sunday, and we have two evenings where the men compete. The shooters come up and qualify. Both female and men competition, by the way.
And that's located right behind the women and the men. We could do that right behind the grandstand.
Yep.
And what's the capacity of this grandstand?
It's about 2,500, and we've added additionally this year. We've added 400 seats across the track. For the events that, like the Hollywood Stunt Show, the tractor pull, and the demolition derby, because every year we sell out, and last year we had a lot of people standing up, and our insurance exposure increases when people are standing up next to the track.
So if there are seats, you better sit down.
Oh,
you want them to sit down. Mm-hmm. How many people does it take to operate the fair that week? I'm talking about people belong to the fair, either you paid or unpaid. How many people would you have employed here?
We have about 35 people working here during the fair.
During the fair. Now, many of those paid?
I'd say about 25 of them are paid.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And plus all the volunteers, of course.
I was going to say,
we have a lot of more volunteers that man each individual department.
Okay. So I thought there'd be more than 35 people. There is more than 35 people.
Definitely. Mm-hmm.
But you've got 35 that are...
keeping the grounds up, picking up the garbage. We contract out the garbage pickup, so those people are considered paid. But with to keep the fair operating, keep everything picked up, keep the plumbing operating and electrical problems that we have about 35 people altogether. 25 of those are paid.
I think we ought to mention one more time about your fair. And very proud of, is one of the cleanest or the cleanest in the state of New York.
We have that reputation. We used to have Mounted State Police coming here, and this guy that came here every year said, I always look forward to coming to this fair. It's the cleanest fair in the state.
And that also, folks, if you're here and you see a tin can, it's just as easy to, a can, a barrel, just as easy to throw your papers in there as it is on the ground.
Definitely so.
Make it a little easier for them. They don't need to, they'll be working anyway whether you throw them on the ground. So... we're just about covered, I guess, all the area. Now, there's a new building you mentioned over in...
the conservation area, if you'd like to walk over that way.
Well, okay, we'll take a walk over in there and see what's going on.
If we could, I'd like to show you the new horse ring that we have, too.
Very well. Mm-hmm. Okay, we'll go right down there now. We're in the conservation building right underneath the trees, the great pine trees here behind the 4-H Club building. And we're standing with Bill LePage, as we have been for the past 45 minutes to nearly an hour. And we're looking at some brand new tables. Tell us about these.
They were made by the inmates in Gabriel's. This is the first year they did that for us. And it's one of the programs that the state does. We supply the building materials, and they put the tables together for us.
These will be outside under the trees?
Yep. In the conservation area, right. And if somebody will buy a lunch from one of the vendors on the grounds, and they'll come over and sit under the trees on a hot day and a breezy day, you know, and take advantage of the shade.
So if you're not sitting under the gazebo, which would be very popular, I'm sure,
yeah.
I'm not sure they want you to eat in there and drop stuff all around.
We're going to use that for that reason, too.
Okay, you're
good. Hopefully they'll pick up their
papers. Oh, I'm sure they will. When everything is picked up, they have a less of an inclination to throw things down, Bill.
That's true.
Okay, now over here we also want to show some new signs. He says he's going to have all new signs put up in front of the buildings. And here's what we're talking. This will be on the outside of the building. These are the new signs, the type of signs, all done also.
Both two-sided also. Both sides.
All right, and that's done by the...
They were done by the inmates.
Go ahead, you take the mic, and I will get this over. Keep talking.
Okay, they were done by the inmates in Gabriel's through the good graces of Superintendent Arthur Abadou and Correction Officer Philip Doby. And we had these brackets made locally so we can hang all these signs from each individual building. That was an idea that was given to us.
Going to here.
Yeah.
And this would be against the building, and you'd be able to see it from either side, correct?
That's correct. That was one of the ideas that came out of the convention in Syracuse this year, too, that all buildings should be signed. And our signs were in pretty bad shape, so we decided to re-sign the whole grounds.
There must be 30 to 40 different stanchions here to hold these, the support, and then all these signs, and these are all...
They're all treated lumber.
Treated lumber, and what I want to say, they're not embossed, but they're just the opposite.
They're engraved.
Engraved, and then painted nice and yellow inside, and it's a great...
They made over 60 signs for us.
It's going to be a great addition. Look for that when you come to the fair. They'll be all up by then.
Yep.
Remember, they've only been open here since Monday. This is the building and all the siding inside. And what do they have in here usually? What will I see here when I come?
Okay. On the side that we're on, we'll have this Clinton County Federation of Fish and Game Clubs. They'll have a beautiful display of taxidermy stuffed animals, Lear and bear and deer heads and animal heads, and it's quite a display. And then on the other side, the DEC usually mans that, and they'll have displays of like fish tanks and things that they do. And on Calvin is scanning now, he's taking in a display of...
Go ahead.
He's taking in a display of saws that was put up here by Ernie Perrier, who was a past member of the board, and his wife Grace. They were these saws come way, as you can see from the dates, they originated way back in the 1800s.
And it's a felling saw to cut the tree. It has a cross cuts. Mm-hmm. And I want to say hello to Grace and Ernie also. Great square dancers.
Oh yes.
And they went back in the late 60s when I was at a little trophy business. I met Ernie and his wife and Harry Carpenter and his wife, and they were very good to me then, and I want to say thank you now, and I want to say hello to both of you.
And I'd, Bob, if I may, I'd like to take the opportunity to thank Ernie for all he's done in the past for the fair. He was a member of the board for 20 years. He resigned this year, and he figured that he had done his share, and I'd like to say that he's done more than his share.
Well, thank you much. Now, this is a very unusual saw. It's the type that you'd have for a crosscut. You got your handle, but on the other hand, you got your helper. This is for the man's end. This is where the wife, which is called togetherness. Grace and Ernie, see? That's togetherness. Now, this is strictly for the man. We got it what they call a spud here, and I think that's used to chip out. Is that chipping? As the old draw shave, a wooden hook. Very popular, the old buck saws. They become a collector's item now. People today are starting to paint on the metal part, and they have them up in their homes.
You can't even buy them nowadays. They're so valuable.
I know that.
They're valuable.
And that's the collection of Grace and Ernie. Are they here just temporarily this year, or is it...
They were here last year, and we left them right up, and they're going to be for everybody's pleasure this year.
And if he leaves them here, he doesn't have to cut wood at home. Grace will take it out and cut wood.
He cuts wood at home with modern tools.
Oh, all right. So we're in this conservation building, and it's a great area. Now, don't miss this building, because you can't see it from the main concourse when you're up the middle. But it's when you come to the 4-H building, come straight through.
By the way, this building was made possible by a donation from the state through the auspices of Senator Stafford. We got a $20,000 grant from them last year to put this building up. And it's something that we had tried to get for a couple of years, and through the graces of the senator, we were fortunate in getting that money.
It was up last year for the fair, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay, we're going to go down. We want to run down and see the horse barn and the horse...
new horse ring.
New horse ring. Mm-hmm. That's where we're going. So come with us. We're drawing to the end of our program, folks, and it's great to have been here with Bill LePage at the Clinton County Fair. And as we look off to our left, and Calvin's got to get that shot of the mountains in the background. You can see the more trees, Bill. It's lovely. You could come here and just stand here and look, right?
Definitely.
And we're standing in front of a circular... No, not quite circular.
No, it's oval horse ring.
Okay.
Oval horse ring.
All right, and it's all newly constructed, you said?
Yes. Yep.
There was one here before.
There was one before, but it was deteriorating. It had been here for about 20 years, and it started to deteriorate pretty fast. So we supplied this treated lumber, and the horse people committee that we have, a very active committee, put this thing together for us, and I think they're to be congratulated. They did a nice job, and it's a professional-looking job for a bunch of amateurs.
Now, also, again, before or after the fair, they can use this.
Oh, yeah. This is used by four or five different clubs every year for their horse shows. And the view that you mentioned from the panoramic view of the mountains that you mentioned here is people enter this show from all over the state. And this is one of the things that they say they come, they just come for the scenery, you know.
Beautiful, yep. Beautiful area. And as I've been walking the grounds and I'm thinking of 80 acres, that's the size of a pretty good farm. And a lot of the farm are 100 or just below. And this is 80 acres. And I always think of the Malone Fair, the Franklin County, because it's right next to the road, and you go by and you always see it. And you've got at least twice as much space as the Franklin County Fair.
That's right, and I've often mentioned to Howard Manelli up in Malone that I'd like to have his attendance, and he says, I'd love to have your grounds.
Yes, he's right there, and people walk up. Yep. You can't walk here, so what?
And, you know, they're on the Route 11 coming through Malone there, and they have an advantage in that respect as far as getting attendance. We have to do quite a bit of advertising for people from out of town or from out of the area to tell them where we are, you know.
Now, do you belong to some kind of fair association?
Yes, the New York State Fair Association, yep. We have a convention, a three-day convention once a year in January in Syracuse. And I get a chance to talk to other managers, and I get a lot of ideas, and we all, for entertainment, anything, all aspects of running the fair, you pick up a lot of good information out at Syracuse.
Bill, when you're not legislating with your other... I can't call it a job, you're not, but it's a good pastime for you.
It sure is.
What do you do, anything else? Are you any other part-time work at all other than your 3 or 4 months here that you spend?
No, the only other thing that I do besides being a legislator and managing the fairgrounds is I work at St. John's. I'm in the Athletic Association there, and I graduated from there, and I've always owed a debt to them, and they're at the fairgrounds here, and they're in the, you know, I help them out as much as I can.
Didn't your brother Bob go to Plattsburgh High School?
No, he went to St. Peter's and MAI.
He did. Yeah. I remember when I knew the family, I knew your brother back when I was 11 and 12 years old. Yeah. And kind of lost him. I did see him recently, though, in the county building.
Right.
And when he mentioned, I was thinking of him when I was coming here to see you today.
Oh,
I was thinking that was Bill, but it's Bob.
Yeah. And well, I have enough to keep me busy. And even though I'm retired, I don't think I'll ever really retire. I'm going to keep doing something. I think everybody should have something to do all the time.
Now, I noticed that there's a truck over here, and there's probably 12 dogs. Is that...
Well, I don't know what the dogs are doing here, but the activity you see in the ring right now is they have a pony club for about 7 days every year where they teach the kids the fineries of horse back riding and show horsing is what they're teaching.
I see you have lights here also.
Yep, they use the ring at night and during the fair time and even during their horse shows. That's a big part of their activities are at night.
Do they have to present any kind of papers to come in here during the day? Like, is anybody stopping them from coming in or letting them come in?
No,
there's no gate?
The only requirement that we have, we don't charge them to use the grounds. The only requirement we have is to ensure us at the fairgrounds, the county, and the town of Plattsburgh.
You did mention to me that the grounds are patrolled by the state police and the county. At least come in, drive by, make sure things are in order.
Right, yeah, that's the security. We don't have security here year-round except for that reason. They're in here quite a few times a day. As they come down 22B, they'll take a swing in and drive around. And that's one of the services that they supply, and it's a good service, let me tell you, because people know that they're here occasionally, you know.
I'm sure people also who are watching this in Plattsburgh and up in the north in the New Channels area think that when you think of Clinton County Fair, you think of a county organization run by the county, and we want to emphasize that.
It's a private corporation of 24 members of a board of directors are incorporated to run this fairgrounds.
All right, and we're right in the middle of the horse area, this whole area here for the horse groups, and that's where the horse shows take place. And Bill, is there anything else that I have not covered that you want to tell to anybody right now?
Well, I think we've pretty well covered the grounds, Bob, but I'd just like to take this opportunity to invite everybody to partake in their fair this year. I think that we've set up quite a program. I forgot to mention, along with our entertainment, we're having a marionette show here for 5 days. They're going to be putting 4 shows a day, and that's great entertainment for the kids. And for 3 days, we were able to get this act called the Mopo Bears that circulate amongst the crowd. Well, they have a little battery remote control car that they drive around, that they have a little imitation bear running around in, and it's quite an act for the kids. And it's to keep them occupied while they're here.
Bill, what day this year is the Children's Day?
That's Wednesday.
Second day of the fair.
The second day of the fair, right. Mm-hmm. And children, and I understand some of the vendors will give some free things to the kids, and they have reduced rides, and it's usually that's a very pretty well attended. They come here early, and I usually have to get after the carnival operator to get those rides going, because I get a lot of complaints if they're not going.
If you're a senior citizen, that's not the best day to come.
No.
You'll get run over with the kids.
By the way, Senior Citizen Day is Thursday, all day Thursday, and there's a $3 admission for all the senior citizens to get in on that day.
Okay, now, I don't usually wear a hat, but this one says I love Champlain. I only did it because I saw him with a Clinton County Fair manager hat for Bill, and Calvin's wearing Hometown Cable hat, so I figured I had to get in style here, but... we want to thank you very much for watching Hometown Cable. You people who up in northern New York and Champlain, Rouses Point, Shazy, Moores, all of you see this regularly. And we want to welcome also you viewers in Plattsburgh, New York, who are looking at your own here, Bill LePage, your legislator, your family man, look at the smile on his face, your manager of your fair. It was a pleasure being here, Bill.
Thank you a lot, Bob, and I want to thank Calvin and you and your organization for giving us a chance to show off our fair.
Thank you, and if you want to see it in action, come here from July 31st
to August 5th.
August the 5th.
Yep.
Don't come once, come often. Get a season ticket for
$14.
That'll take care of any adult. Otherwise, it's $4 a day.
That's right. So you save $10 by buying a season ticket.
And if you're coming six times a day, you're saved. Look how much you'd save then. That'd be that's $120 you'd be spending, and you can get it all for $14.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Thanks very much for watching Hometown Cable. And you people in Plattsburgh, keep watching the schedule. There's going to be a lot of shows that you'll enjoy, a lot of ball games, a lot of graduations, a lot of local events. Look for your relatives, your friends, and even people you don't like very much. They're going to be on, too. Bob Venn with What's Going On Here, saying goodbye from the fair, and our guest, Bill LePage.